Welcome back to MPS Talks. My name is Dr. Matthew Joseph, and I'm the Director of Digital Learning, Informational Technology, and Innovation in the Milford Public Schools. It has been great to be able to work with so many amazing educators here in Milford and across the state. In our last Twitter chat that we had at hashtag MPS Learns, our Assistant Superintendent, Craig Consigli, talked about being visible in the classroom and in schools, and it helps build relationships. That really got me thinking about what it takes to be a more visible leader. In my 11 years of being a building principal, and now the past 3 years as a district leader, I've seen the role of school administrator evolve from a building manager into an instructional leader. Today's school administrator has an overabundance of duties and responsibilities to balance with the mandates from the state and national reform. Today's administrator must assist in teaching and learning situations and the educational needs of a school and its educators. I feel an instructional leader consists of assisting in teaching and learning situations and the needs of the school and its educators. As an instructional leader, you must guide teachers to align learning experiences with the stated or planned learning objectives. Then create learning activities to be aligned with the chosen objective to emphasize student achievement. And that is our goal each and every day. So leaders should monitor instruction relentlessly and develop a very clear and well-defined curriculum, all while ensuring quality instruction, promoting best practices, monitoring the implementation of curriculum, providing resources to teachers, and examining assessment data. So how are educational leaders going to do all that? Well, going back to Craig's answer, my answer is about being visible and having a pulse on the building. Building administrators must know the instructional practices of the school to fully assume the role of instructional leader. Administrators are responsible for fairly evaluating educators and providing feedback for their growth. So getting out of the office and seeing what's going on in the school is critical to being an instructional leader. By getting out of the office, a leader is able to take that pulse of what is actually happening inside and outside of the classroom. Visibility is an extremely important characteristic of a strong school leader and one of the most difficult to accomplish. Whether it is initiating a spur of the moment discussion in the hallway or even spending time with the staff either on the fly or more of a systematic practice of checking in with educators each day. Visibility and accessibility positively influence job satisfaction and the culture of a school. So today I want to note 7 ways to be more visible and for our leaders to get out of the office and we can really see what's going on in the building. Some that I've used and some that I've seen in practice. One is wandering purposely. This method of leadership was a strategy actually incorporated by Hewlett-Packard in the early stages of that company. Packard believed that to be a successful manager, you should be out in the field or in the workroom floor and away from the desk at least half of the day. In my last podcast or episode, I talked about giving credit. I actually read that in an article from Peters and Waterman, and they wrote that in 1982. This concept in our K-12 school will allow leaders to understand the instructional needs of their schools and be in a better position to themselves make informed decisions that will impact student learning. I think visibility is critical. However, visibility alone will do little to improving a school. Productively, you have to be visible and couple that with a well-focused visit. So if you are using the management by wandering around strategy, ensure you are focused and capture visual evidence of what you saw, and maybe even keep a journal of your walks. Also, try to vary the times and locations to include maybe even pick up in the morning or drop off or lunch or team meetings and definitely some other non-instructional settings. Another strategy is classroom visits. Collaboration increases when staff feel the leader is visible. You cannot lead collaboration without having the pulse of the building or the district. For school leaders to be visible and have the knowledge of instructional practice to deliver growth-providing feedback, you will need to implement multiple methods of classroom visits to be visible and build the relationship. So being visible will help leaders understand the practice and understand the building. observe the dynamics of the teacher to student, the student to student, and teacher to teacher relationship to foster both trust with your staff and your knowledge of the building. When you do that, maybe the next step is teach a class. Take that visit to the next step and maybe teach a class. Encourage teachers to observe you as the leader teaching their class. Use that time to actually model some instructional practices you feel strongly about and want others to use and teach their students themselves. You can use that time for conversation by reflecting with the teacher on how the lesson you just taught worked or didn't and how the students learn, and observe the teacher's depth and understanding of pedagogy in those conversations. So outside of the classroom, maybe have lunch with students. When staff observe their leader connecting with students, they'll be more open to collaboration if you model that collaborative thinking and reinforce what you are there for. And the teachers and the students see all of that by having lunch with the students. And at bottom line, it's just fun and you get to know your students. Take it one step further by inviting key community members to join you for enlightening school lunch with these students. Now that you've had lunch, maybe another strategy could be serving lunch in the cafeteria. Eating is definitely one way to be more visible, and so is supporting your kitchen staff. Be visible and get a lot of that positive chatter going by serving food or passing out milk during lunch. This strategy will also allow you to observe student behavior in a less structured environment and reinforce your expectation of manners and cooperation. One of my favorites is go out and play on the playground. As an elementary school principal, I love this. This strategy doesn't need to have much explanation, but is a great way to have fun, be part of your school, and have staff see you outside of the classroom. And bottom line, the kids will love it. Take it even outside of the school, be involved in the community. This last strategy I'll break down into a few parts because it looks different being involved with the community, and each part is important for different reasons. Being involved outside of the walls of the school allows the community members the opportunity to get to know and hear their school leader. It's also a time that a leader can provide and market their schools as well. So a couple ideas. You could speak at school programs. Speaking briefly at a school night or an off-site program like a youth organization or a church organization, this will provide an opportunity to establish expectations or reinforce to the audience etiquette, share importance of information, give public praise, talk about your students, your staff, parents, and actually advocate for what your school needs and is doing well. You can also use social media. Set up a social media account. We use Twitter a lot here in Milford Public Schools and start sharing all the wonderful things that happen each and every day. If you don't like Twitter, as I said, find another social media outlet such as Instagram or Facebook. Remind is a great tool, or use your school website to get that information out. These updates take just a few minutes and can provide parents with a strong connection to the school and to you as the school leader. You can also send out handwritten notes. One of the best ways to connect and create an authentic bond is to go reach out to people and tell them that they matter. Spend a day writing a friendly note, or just say hello and drop it in the mail. Or do the same thing for your staff and leave a note in the mailboxes, or just say hello when they aren't expecting it. If there is time and you are writing a note to your staff, deliver in person. It's about the connections that you're making that breed the collaboration, not just the visibility alone. School leaders need to be available, approachable, and visible. If leaders spend all of their time in the office, how will they know what staff, students, and families need, or what is working well to celebrate in the school? It's not about checking on employees or supervising, but it's rather a genuine desire to interact with staff and students and provide a positive, vibrant, and visible presence in the school. So thank you, Milford Public Schools, for tuning in the Milford community. At the start, I noted that we are having Twitter chats, hashtag MPSLearn. Check it out, we have them every couple weeks, or you can just put that hashtag in the search. See all the great things that are happening. Talking about great things, that's another hashtag. Hashtag MPS great things. So thank you for tuning in, and continue to tune in to this podcast and show and all the amazing shows that are happening here at Milford TV. We are very lucky to have such a fabulous resource here in our community to share both about schools as we did today and all the community events like schools and music programs and all the great things that we are doing. We're talking about being visible. Milford Television makes that possible here for the Milford community. So I thank Milford TV and I look forward to continued collaboration with Milford TV and Milford Public Schools and our community at large. It is a great resource. Have a great afternoon, Milford community.